evening. Welcome to the Battling Years show with me, Lady J, on Ben TV with Interface Gambia. As we enter the Lent season, I'll be explaining the basic guidelines expected of all Christians during this very solemn period, as well as playing some of the most popular hymns. I would like to explain the meaning of Lent. The word Lent is derived from the Middle English word lente, meaning springtime, and lasts for a period of 40 days from Ash Wednesday to Easter, observed as a time of penance, meaning sorrow for sin and conversion to God, and fasting by all Christians. Ash Wednesday is the practice of marking Christians' foreheads with crosses made of ashes as a sign of repentance to start the Lent journey. Before I play the first hymn, which I think is quite fitting and appropriate, please join me as I read the Gospel according to Matthew chapter 4, verses 1 to 11, the temptation of Jesus. Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the desert to be tempted by the devil. After fasting for 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. The tempter came to him and said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread." Jesus answered, "It is written, man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God." Then the devil took him to the holy city and had him stand on the highest point of the temple. "If you are the Son of God," he said, "throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and they will lift you up in their hands, so that you will not strike your feet against the stone." Jesus answered, "It is also written, do not put the Lord your God to the test." Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdom of the world and their splendor. "All this I will give you," he said, "if you will bow down and worship me." Jesus said to him, "Away from me, Satan, for it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only." Then the devil left, and angels came and attended to Jesus. This is the word of the Lord. My next hymn I've chosen appropriately because 40 is a very big number in the Bible, and whatever God wanted to do, if you look at it, it will take about 40 days. So for Jesus to spend 40 days in the desert, hungry and praying, the first hymn I would like to play today, which is one of all-time favorite in Lent, 40 Days and 40 Nights.
Thank you.
enjoyed that hymn, and I was singing along in the studio, as that is one of our all-time favorite. I would like to talk to you about what Lent is and what it's not about. Because I know a lot of us, we know basically Lent is for fasting, Lent is for doing good, Lent is for, you know, what for whatever reason we might describe Lent as. But growing up in a Christian environment and being in a religious family, I know most of us know the basic and what is needed and what is not needed to be done during Lent. I would like to just highlight a few things that a Christian must really follow during Lent and what not to do. Basically, Lent is not a Christian's New Year's resolution. Lent is not a Christian endurance contest. And it's not about choosing who you want to forgive or who you want to talk to or who you feel like you were not talking to for a long time, you just want to talk to the person now because it's Lent. Lent is not about being a Christian just during the 40 days and the 40 nights that Jesus was in the desert. And it's not just about fasting or just, you know, it's not just about because it's Lent, okay, I have to be holy. No. Precisely, the number 40 is a very special number in the Bible because it signifies preparation for something, something special, looking in both the Old and the New Testament. There are a few examples of what 40 days means in the Bible. So 40, like I said, is very significant in the Bible, and it's got various things that God has performed during these 40 days. Like, for example, in Noah, in like say Noah's Ark, the rain lasted for 40 days in the mighty flood, and Moses stayed on the Mount Sinai listening to God for 40 days, to which he received the 10 commandments that we almost live for. And then, if we remember the Israelites, they spent 40 days wandering in the desert because they made God angry, and he did that to them as a punishment. And then there was Jonah. Jonah gave the people of Nineveh 40 days to repent for their sins. And then Jesus himself, now that we are celebrating and we are commemorating Lent, Jesus was given 40 days in the desert to pray and fast and prepare for his ministry. So Lent is basically not just whatever you think, oh, I'm going to be good, or I'm going to do this, or I'm going to fast, and then everything will work. No. Lent is a time when Christians remember the 40 days and nights Jesus spent alone in the desert, preparing for the start of his ministry by praying and by fasting, and with all the temptations that been brought to him, tested by God, just to see whether he will be able to fulfill his ministry. So, in other words, Lent is a time of soul searching and change of heart. So, I am going to play another hymn, and then after that, we will come to what Lent is about really. What exactly is expected of all of us as Christians during this Lent season. My next hymn I chose is, I think, is a song, is a hymn that refreshes you, prepares you, gets you ready properly for Lent, or whatever commitments you would like to do in your life towards God. So my next hymn is Soul of My Savior, which I know is quite popular with everyone. So Soul of My Savior.
Oh,
welcome back, and I hope you enjoyed that hymn. I was just talking about what Lent is about and what is expected of all Christians during this Lenten season. Like I said before, Lent is a time of soul searching and a change of heart. Lent is a time of penance, and Lent is like a campaign for holiness. Lent is a time to live the Christian life. Lent is a time for sharing your faith. Lent is about stripping away the distractions in your life so that you can focus on getting closer to the Lord. And Lent, the most important thing is Lent is about preparing for Easter. Easter is the biggest celebration in the liturgical year. So you have to be ready for it. And the way to get ready for Easter is to prepare during Lent. Like I said, Lent is not a time for you to sit down and say, okay, I'm going to forgive someone, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, or I'm not going to sin anymore, so I'll be fine for the rest of my life. It is something that you commit yourself to, and you live the Christian life, and then you put it in action by doing good things, by sacrificing some time in your life. Sometime when you're not doing anything much, you sacrifice by going to charity shops to help, or you go to the homes to help the old people, or just to do something good in the will of God. That's what Lent is trying to portray to us, what we can do to change our life as Christians and believers. This Lent, make it a challenge in your life to say, I'm not giving up chocolate. Because a lot of people during Lent, that's when they say, oh, I'm going to give up as my penance, I'm going to give up chocolate, or I'm going to give up smoking, I'm going to give up drinking or going to nightclubs. But really, if as a Christian, you want to be involved in the commemoration of the dying of the Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord, by looking at how he died for us, he chose to do it for us with sincerity, if I must say. I'm so sorry about that, but with sincerity, when I say sincerity, I mean he did it for nothing. So by saying I'm going to give up chocolate or I'm going to give up drinking or so, is it just for the time of Lent? Is it just forever? How much time limit do you think you'll give yourself? But the best thing to do during Lent is to say that, okay, I'm going to give up being a sinner. I'm going to give up committing any sin in the name of the Lord. So I think, and the basic understanding is, Lent is the climax of Lent is the commemoration of the suffering, the death, and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. So it is really a time to deepen our relationship with Christ. Doing small things with great intentions will help further our faith, e.g. attending daily mass and stations of the cross, volunteering at a local homeless shelter, praying for the poor people around the world, you know, giving up something that you really love as a sign of love to someone. And during these 40 days of Lent, there are certain things that you are expected to do as a Christian. Like, for instance, you are supposed to read a prayer for something every single day of those 40 days. Every day from day one of Lent to the 40 days have got a special prayer or a special act that you're supposed to perform, and fast as well, for you to celebrate the period of Lent. And that doesn't include the Sundays, because Sunday is not counted towards the 40 days of Lent, because Sunday in the Christian religion is seen as a day of celebration. So definitely Sunday is not counted during the 40 days of Lent. And I don't know whether a lot of people, or most of you, know when you go to church, do you take notice of the colors that they put in church? Because during Lent, the color that the church puts on, like as if in the robe that the priests wear, or what is the linen that is put on the altar, is all supposed to be purple, because purple or violet is the color for Lent, which shows that the church is in mourning, as it's in Lent, that's the time they lost Jesus Christ our Lord. And so by, like, just what I just said is, I feel that during this Lenten period is the time when Jesus really did show us his grace. And the next hymn I'm going to be playing at this moment is Amazing Grace. Amazing Grace, when you look at the words, you know, really, 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 Jesus has amazed us because he's done something amazing. So my next hymn is Amazing Grace. Back, and I hope you did enjoy that hymn as well. Now, the 40 days of Lent have a special prayer dedicated to each day, which most of you will know. I will be reading them one by one from 1 to 40. So if there's any kids watching, you can grab a paper and a pen and write down what you should be doing every day, each day of Lent to the 40 days. Now, I know that people might see me, Lady J, sitting down here talking about Lent. I might be wrong, I might be right in some cases, but I think basically what I've just said is things that are like factual to the Bible, and I've just put it down in a basic way. So I'm not a pastor, but still, these are just a bit of knowledge that I know from childhood, and I know most of you will share it with me. My favorite hymn is "When I Survey the Wondrous Cross." And the reason why this song is my favorite hymn is because every time they played this song, my mom, I could always, when I was a child, I could see my mom. She would express herself, she would express her feelings. She will be singing this hymn until she's crying, and the way she lifts her hands up in praise of the Lord, just because of this song. And there's a particular verse in the song, in the hymn, that she's always expressing. And she says to me, she always taught me that as a Christian, you should always survey the cross. Because when you stand in front of that cross, you see a lot and you think a lot about what Jesus Christ our Lord has done for us. So when it says, "When I survey the wondrous cross," and then it says, there's a verse there that says, "See from his head, his hands, his feet, sorrow and love flew mingled down. Did ever such love and sorrow meet?" And then it says, "And thorns compose so much rich of a crown." Now, that verse, the particular reason why I choose to discuss about that verse is, if we think about the love that Christ showed us, the way he gave up himself as a sacrifice, just to save us from sin, how much more could we give back? How much more could we do? How much more do we do? Just to think about that, when it says, "I survey," you stand there as a Christian and you survey the cross and you look at it and you see everything like love, sorrow, suffering, all coming down that cross. You should think well as a Christian and do good, not just because of Lent, but all the days of your life. Lent, I can sit here all day saying, "Oh, do this, or do that, or don't do that, or don't do that." Who made me say that? I can't say that to anybody. It's you within your heart, what you feel, what you think you should do. Me, as Lady J sitting here talking, I will try. I have done my best, and I will try. Because it never ends. It's every day what you do, what you say, and how you do it, and what you do to help other people who are less fortunate that matters. Now, I will not play the "When I Survey the Wondrous Cross" now. I will save that for later because I know it's the biggest favorite for all of you. The next hymn I would like to play would be a hymn that I know everyone likes as well, and they will love to listen to, because it is a song that is very, it is a hymn that is very, very, very important. And when you think of the hymn, you will definitely know what I'm saying, because you will need that hymn, that prayer. This, because the hymn is like a prayer as well. It's a hymn that asks God, who asks Jesus Christ at this time, to look down upon us, to save us, to draw us near. So the next hymn will be "God of Mercy and Compassion," and I think we do need that at this moment. Next hymn, "God of Mercy and Compassion."
God of mercy and compassion.
I hope you enjoyed that hymn. I did. We'll be right back after this short break.
In my line of duty, I believe in being fast and reliable. That's the reason why I use Supersonics for all my money transfers. With Supersonics, you can transfer money online from anywhere in the world to Africa, Asia, and Europe. They are affordable, they are reliable, and fast. Use Supersonics online, on the phone, and any of their branches. Supersonics, the one.
The 40 days of Lent have a special prayer dedicated to each day, and I'll be going through that with you as at now, so that you know that each day of Lent, from day 1 to day 40, you know what to pray for, so that it will be a complete Lenten season for you. Okay, I start with the first one. Number 1, pray for hunger. Number 2, pray for strength for those in despair. Number 3, pray that a child's future is guided by God's love and service. And then number 4, pray for those who are newlywed. Number 5, pray for the sanctity of an inmate's life. Number 6, pray for humility. Number 7, pray for insight when opinions differ. Number 8, you pray to be fully nourished with his word, body, and blood. Number 9, pray for victims of natural disaster to have endurance to be rebuild their lives again. Number 9, pray for victims of natural disaster to have endurance to rebuild their lives. Number 10, pray for addicts to fight temptation so as to seek recovery. Number 11, pray for the world, Lord's word to prevail in the mass media. Number 12, pray for modesty and discretion in fashion trends. Number 13, pray for you to be stirred with the spirit of giving. Number 14, pray for clarity and direction when faced with financial challenges. Number 15, pray for foresight when starting a project. Now, we've got up to number 15, and I believe that all these prayers, they have a significance and how it will work during the Lent. So, by fasting, by praying, and by keeping yourself holy, God will answer all these prayers. In other times, you don't have to just pray because it says in the Bible or it says in the Catholic religion that you should do these prayers. But these are prayers that you look at what is needed, how it could be done, and how God will answer your prayers, and it will be received in the name of the Lord if you do it during this time and the specific time that it says there. So when I say one, it means the first day of Lent, which is from Ash Wednesday. And then you come down up to the 15th day of Lent. Now, we stopped at 15th. We're going to go to 16 now and continue. Assist a neighbor with an ordinary task. That is one task in between the 15 that I've just said. That is a task because it involves a prayer and a task in between. Now, the 17th one is pray and seek forgiveness for a transgression against a friend. Pray for strength to speak out on behalf of the Lord. Visit someone who is ill, like someone who is in hospital that you know, someone who is suffering from some kind of illness and hasn't got anybody to help them. You could visit them at home, you could visit them in the hospital, wherever they are, just to give them a helping hand and give them courage. That will help as well. And then pray for compromise between friends and family who disagree. And then number 21, you pray for honesty in the mass media. Number 22, pray for a loved one who has suffered a loss. And at this point, we remember people who just died recently, like our Archbishop, Reverend Bishop Tilewa Johnson. And at the same time, we remember a lady who just died, who died like a few days ago, Mary Cold, commonly known as Mariam Jallo. And then we remember people like Auntie Eva, who has done so much in our community. We pray for them that their soul will rest in perfect peace. And then number 23, we prayed for continued inspiration throughout the remaining season of Lent, which is we pray to be inspired to continue the journey that we started with Lent. And then number 24, you share a gift of treasure with a charity association. So whatever you love best, whatever you think you love to your heart contents, you try to give it up to a charity that will make something in helping somebody who is less fortunate. And then number 25, refrain from harsh language and never use the Lord's name in vain. Like for instance, when we are saying something and we just got up and say, Bilai, I swear to God, and you know you're not telling the truth. Those are examples of using God's name in vain. You shouldn't do that. And then he says, number 26, pray for restraint when urged to take credit for his wondrous work. That means do not let somebody tell you, oh, you are doing God's work fine. Oh, you are spreading the news very well. Don't take credit in that way. And then number 27, pray for patience and understanding between couples. If you have particular friends, if you have close relatives, that are in dispute at the moment, pray for them to come together, because God will answer your prayer at this Lenten season. Pray for them to come together. Pray for them to understand each other, that marriage is not built in a day. Pray for them to come together so God will answer your prayer. So this is the best time to pray for them, and that is the Lenten number day of number 27, the 27th day of Lent. If you pray for any couple that is in trouble, God will help them. So number 29, pray for the uninspired to have faith in God, which is very important, because there are people there who do not believe there is a God. May God forgive us. But there are some people who believe like that. So pray for them to be drawn to some belief that they could live in the right path of God. Number 30, confront someone. And it says confront, which means go to somebody. Meet up with somebody who, it says, confront someone who has trespassed against you and seek peace with a calm reason. When it says confront, it doesn't mean for you to go and just start fighting or arguing or bringing up something that is not called for. When it says confront, you get up on your 2 feet and go and meet somebody whom you had a difference with and resolve it calmly. God will help you in that as well. That's one of the things that you're supposed to do Lent. So do not feel bad to do that at all. Number 31 says, pray for an overwhelmed friend to have a respite from all daily worries. Some people like me worry for nothing. Worry for this, worry for that, worry for anything. So you pray for them that they will be, in our community now we say stress-free. We pray for them to be stress-free. And then number 32, pray for a child who has lost respect for their elders. And that is so much in this community now. I think we all do need to pray for that, because the elderly are our people who worked so hard for us. We pray for them. So every child should respect their elders. So we pray for them. If we see a child who has disrespected their elders in anyhow, do not say, oh, leave him alone, let's walk away from him. Also pray for them. Pray for them to come back and acknowledge their parents or whoever it is that is elderly to them. 33, pray for enlightenment for those who tend towards self-destructive behaviors. People who just wish to do bad to themselves. Maybe it's the devil behind them. You pray for them to be relieved from that. Number 34, pray for those who have strayed from the word, from his word, from the word of the Lord. Bring them back that they may experience and accept the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. Take someone to the Sacred Triduum service with you. That's number 35. And number 36, pray to gain his wisdom when faced with a painful personal challenge. You pray for his wisdom, you pray for relief, you pray for him to guide you in the right path. Number 37, pray for divine wisdom to enter your humble heart, not to have any grudges, not to keep any restraint in your heart. That's what it means, divine wisdom, that you might be free from all restraint, you yourself. Number 38, pray for the satisfaction of spiritual nourishment within yourself. You need to have the fulfillment of the Lord in you. Your heart be filled with fulfillment, sacrifice, excitement about your Lord the God for what he has done for you, especially during this Lent time. Pray for God's peace to dwell in anyone who has recently lost a loved one. We pray for the kids who have lost their mom at the same time again. Pray for someone who has lost their husbands or their wives. And then the 40th one is pray for a blessed Easter season. Now, Easter is the time when the church is the biggest celebration in the church. You pray for it to come nicely, you receive it calmly. Because like I said, the climax of Lent is the commemoration of the suffering, the death, and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. That was the 40 prayers I just listed out to you for the Lenten season, each day of the Lent season. So please do follow those ones, or, you know, just do as it says on it. Now, I have a closing prayer, which I would like to say Now, before I play my last hymn, I would like to say this prayer just for all of us on our behalf. And it is, may our worship, prayers, and penitence be sustained throughout this Lenten season until the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ at Easter and thereafter. We pray this in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, my next hymn will be, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross. I know you all will like this hymn. It is a favorite, so I decided to play it today for you. Hymn I enjoyed that I was singing in the studio. I hope you enjoyed it. Please join me on Good Friday with my guests that I'll have here on the Bartie Lingel Show. Have a blessed Lenten season. We at Interface Gambia would like to thank you all our sponsors, Supersonics, the Gambia Tourism Board, Miss Faith Cold, and Mr. Mo Samba. And we thank you all for watching the Bartie Lingel Show. I hope what I said did help. If not, please tell me your views. And we at Interface Gambia, we're still looking for sponsors. If in this Lenten season you feel good and all right, please do help us in any case. Every help is welcome, and we do appreciate all what you have done for us the past months. So we thank you very much, and we'd like to say to you, without you, Interface Gambia wouldn't have been doing so much good. So keep the good help coming. Thank you. We pray for your continued blessedness. Thank you very much.